Please turn to 351 in the Book of Common Prayer, page 351. Bless the Lord who forgives all our sins.
His mercy endures forever.
Reading is from Genesis. Now the Lord said to Abram, "Go from your country and your kindred and your father's house to the land that I will show you. I will make of you a great nation, and I will bless you and make your name great, so that you will be a blessing. I will bless those who bless you, and the one who curses you I will curse. And in you all the families of the earth shall be blessed." So Abram went, as the Lord had told him. Let us read Psalm 121 after, and respond after the answer. I lift up my eyes to the hills.
Where is my help to come?
My help comes from the Lord,
the maker of heaven and earth.
He will not let your foot be moved.
And he who watches over you will not fall asleep.
Behold, he who keeps watch over Israel
shall neither slumber nor sleep.
The Lord himself watches over you.
The Lord is your shade and your right hand.
evil.
In his seed shall he keep safe.
The Lord shall watch over your going out and your coming in.
From this time forth, forevermore.
Do apart from the presence of God.
Jesus answered him, "Very truly I tell you, no one can see the kingdom of God without being born from above." Nicodemus said to him, "How can anyone be born after having grown old? Can one enter a second time into the mother's womb and be born?" Jesus answered, "Very truly I tell you, no one can enter the kingdom of God without being born of water and spirit. What is born of the flesh is flesh. What is born of the spirit is spirit. Do not be astonished that I said to you, you must be born from above. The wind blows where it chooses, and you hear the sound of it, but you do not know where it comes from or where it goes. So it is with everyone who is born of the Spirit." Nicodemus said to him, "How can these things be?" Jesus answered him, "Are you a teacher of Israel, and yet you do not understand these things? Very truly I tell you, we speak of what we know and testify to what we have seen, that you do not receive our testimony. If I have told you about earthly things and you do not believe, how can you believe if I tell you about heavenly things? No one has ascended into heaven except the one who descended from heaven, the Son of Man. And just as Moses lifted up the serpent in the wilderness, so must the Son of Man be lifted up, that whoever believes in him may have eternal life. For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, so that everyone who believes in him may not perish, but may have eternal life. Indeed, God did not send the Son into the world to condemn the world, but in order that the world might be saved through him." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
Nicodemus coming to Jesus. And if you know, he comes at night. It's the only time in all four Gospels that we have someone approaching Jesus at night. And what we know from the story is Nicodemus is part of the Sanhedrin, the 70 men who actually are the controlling the political faction of Israel and make the legal decision for it. He comes at night, granting to Jesus that Jesus has to be someone that is from God because of the gifts and the power that Jesus has in healing and in preaching. And then Jesus continues in the discussion to to reveal to Nicodemus that it is through the Spirit, and water, that we come to be fully anointed as the sons and daughters of God. Nicodemus has trouble with this. It is not clear on exactly what is going on. And Nicodemus has begun that internal judgment, that internal journey by which he will grow more and more into understanding the gifts that God offers, and then how Jesus is the intermediary for that. And yet again, if you know, there's a pattern of development of faith for Nicodemus. If you will, it is what to me is the most beautiful prayer in all of the New Testament. When Jesus asks a man whose son is possessed, and Jesus says, "Do you believe?" And the man replies in Mark 9th chapter, "I believe, Lord, but help my unbelief." Doesn't have to be crystal clear. Doesn't have to be perfect. All it is God accepts us where we're at. It doesn't require us to be beyond what we're capable of believing at the time. All we need is that kernel of faith, and God provides. Later in John's Gospel, in chapter 7, Jesus is preaching in the temple during the Feast of the Tabernacle. And during that time, the palace and temple guard are debating whether to arrest Jesus, because a number of people are starting to follow him. And you know, he's not a certified, he doesn't have a degree, he's not certified to do this. And he's going against some of the ideas that the Jewish people hold and practice at that point in time. And so when the temple police come to the Sanhedrin and tell them that they have not arrested him, the Sanhedrin says, "Well, why not? You know, you had your chance. Why didn't you arrest the man?" And Nicodemus speaks up and he said, "Isn't it in our law that a man has to come and profess what he is doing before we can arrest him?" Nicodemus is growing in his faith, growing at least to risk this, even though at the time the members of the Sanhedrin look at him and say, "What, are you from Galilee too? We know the Messiah is not to come from there." But at least Nicodemus is starting to have more faith and more courage. And then ultimately we know the courage that Nicodemus has, because at the crucifixion, he is the man who provides the spices to prepare the body of Jesus before it is laid in the tomb. By this time, he no longer has the fear, but he has a willingness to stand out and express what he believes. I think if each of us looks back at our own lives, hopefully we can see times where God has called us into a different way of believing and a different way of acting. I know in my own case there were situations, there were people placed in my life that that point in time to help me go beyond the comfort zone that I had. I can remember especially at Christmas when I was home from Marquette University, and a priest friend came over to the house and excused my language, young man. He said, why in the hell don't you get where you belong? In other words, what he was saying is, quit horsing around in Marquette and get into the seminary so that you can be ordained as a priest. And that was a turning point. It was a definitely turning point in my life. There were other times, such as when I was discerning whether or not to ask the Episcopal Church to receive my ordination so that I can function as a priest once more. And I asked 5 different people to pray over it. With the exception of my wife, none of them were Episcopalians. But all of them came back with the same answer. Yes, go to the bishop and ask. I think in each of our lives, we have been touched by people like that. People who can help us, whether it is in making difficult decisions or whether it's going through difficulties in our life, so that we know truly that God does love us, that God cares for us, that God wants what is best for us. And if we but trust God and plant our feet firmly in midair, we know God will hold us, God will bless us, and God will call us to be all that we are called to be. For those of you who are able, please rise and let us pray together our Nicene Creed. We believe in one God,
the Father and the Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Pray to the Lord, saying, Lord, have mercy. remembering especially in the diocesan cycle of prayer, St. David's Holy, for the Holy Church of God, that it may be filled with truth and love and be found with fault at the day of your coming. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For Michael, our presiding bishop, for Joseph, our own bishop, for all bishops and other ministries, for all the holy people of God. We pray for you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For all who fear God and believe in you, Lord Christ, that our division may cease and that all may be one as you and the Father are one. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the mission of the church and this parish and our discernment process, that in faithful witness it may preach the gospel to the ends of the earth. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For those who do not yet believe, and for those who have lost their faith, that they may receive the light of the gospel, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace of the world, that a spirit of respect and forbearance may grow among the nations and peoples, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For those in position of public trust, that they may serve justice and promote the dignity and freedom of every person, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For all who live and work in this community, especially first responders and healthcare workers, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For a blessing upon all human labor and for the right use of the riches of creation, that the Lord may be freed from poverty, famine, disaster. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the poor, the persecuted, the sick, and all who suffer, for refugees, prisoners, and all who are in danger, that they may be relieved and protected. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this congregation, for those who are present, for those who are absent, that we may be delivered from the hardness of heart, and show forth your glory in all that we do. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our enemies and those who wish us harm, and for all who we have injured or offended, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
And for ourselves, for the forgiveness of our sins, and for the grace of the Holy Spirit to amend our lives, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For all who have commended themselves to prayers, especially those on our parish prayer list, for our families, friends, and neighbors, that being freed from anxiety, they may live in joy, peace, and health. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For all who have died in the communion of your church, those whose faith is known to you alone, that we, as all the saints, they may have rest in that place where there is no pain or grief, but life eternal. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Rejoicing in the fellowship of all the saints, let us commit ourselves and one another and all our life to Christ our God.
To you, O Lord our God.
You turn to the inside right page of your bulletin. Let us pray together the prayer for our parish discernment.
Almighty and heavenly God, ruler of all things in heaven and earth, hear our prayers for this parish family. Guide us in our discernment, that with thankful hearts, we may seek and call our next rector in accordance with your will, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And also with you.
We're going to sing it.
Peace. Peace. Peace.
Peace.
Peace. Peace of the Lord.
Thank you. Are there any announcements?
Does anyone have announcements? Tom?
Crystal? Today's service tonight, we have live music. Terry Couture will be playing guitar for us tonight, so certainly if you're interested, we'll see you.
And then before I ask that the gifts be brought up, I'm going to bless two groups of items here on the altar. First of all, these rings are rings of gratitude that those children who come here on Monday after school made, because last Monday it was raining, but they are delightful, not only in the things that they added, but some of the pictures that they drew that only a child could draw. And we give thanks for these gifts and these expressions of thanks. We also give thanks for the after-school program on Monday and the ways in which these children are blessed by those volunteers who, from the church here, who work to nurture them. And then we also have the Bare Essentials 25 feminine hygiene kits, which will be sent to Africa, to Swaziland, to an outreach group there, Luke's mission in the next days. And we bless these gifts, and we bless these women who will be given them. They may realize how much God loves them. And we give thanks for this special group of people at Luke's commission. This we ask in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Let us walk in love as Christ loved us. Let us bring our gifts to the altar.
Oh,
you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give him thanks and praise.
God of all power, ruler of the universe, you are worthy of glory and praise.
Glory to you forever and ever.
At your command, all things came to be, the vast expanse of interstellar space, galaxies, suns, the planets in their courses, and this fragile earth, our island home.
By your will, they were created and have their being.
With the primal elements, you brought forth the human race, and blessed us with memory, reason, and skill. You made us the rulers of creation, but we turned against you and betrayed your trust, and we turned against one another.
Have mercy, Lord, for we are sinners in your sight.
Again and again you called us to return. To the prophets and sages you revealed your righteous law. And in the fullness of time you sent your only son, born of a woman, to fulfill your law. And open for us the way of freedom and peace.
By his blood he reconciled us. By his wounds we are healed.
And therefore we praise you, joining with the heavenly chorus, with prophets, apostles, and martyrs, with all those in every generation who have looked to you in hope, to proclaim with them your glory and their unending hymn. Supper, you took the cup of wine. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me. Remember now his work of redemption and offer to you this sacrifice of thanksgiving.
Death and resurrection as we await the day of his coming.
Lord God of our fathers and mothers, God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, Sarah, Rachel, Rebecca, and Leah, God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, open our eyes to see your hand at work in the world about us. Deliver us from the presumption of coming to this table for solace only, not for strength, for pardon only and not for renewal. Let the grace of this Holy Communion make us one body, one spirit in Christ, that we may worthily serve the world in his name.
Risen Lord, be known to us in the breaking of the bread.
Accept these prayers and praises, Father, for Jesus Christ, our great high priest, and with you and the Holy Spirit, the church gives honor, glory and worship from generation to generation.
Amen.
Now our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Christ, our Passover, is sacrificed for us.
Therefore, let us keep the peace.
The gifts of God for the people of God. Let us take them in remembrance. Christ died for us. Let us feed on him in our hearts by faith with thanksgiving.
Thank you.
365 in the Book of Common Prayer. Let us pray. Eternal God, Heavenly Father, you have graciously accepted us as living members of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. And you have fed us with spiritual food in the sacrament of his body and blood. Send us now into our world peace and grant us strength and courage to love and serve you with gladness and singleness of heart. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Keep this your family, Lord, with your never-failing mercy, relying solely on the help of your heavenly grace, they may be upheld by your divine protection through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Into the world, rejoicing in the power of the Spirit.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mickey. Thank you.